Harris says she'll press Congress to pass a federal ban on price gouging for food and groceries, but details are yet to be defined.
You want to expand the child tax credit?
Yes, I do.
You want to give tax breaks to first-time homebuyers?
Yes.
And people starting small businesses?
Correct.
But it is estimated by the Nonpartisan Committee for Responsible Federal Budget that your economic plan would add $3 trillion to the federal deficit over the next decade. How are you going to pay for that?
Okay, so the other economists that have reviewed my plan versus my opponent and determined that my economic plan would strengthen America's economy, his would weaken it.
But
my plan, Bill, if you don't mind, my plan is about saying that when you invest in small businesses, you invest in the middle class, and you strengthen America's economy. Small businesses are part of the backbone of America's economy.
But pardon me, Madam Vice President, the question was, how are you going to pay for it?
Well, one of the things is I'm going to make sure that the richest among us who can afford it pay their fair share in taxes. It is not right that teachers and nurses and firefighters are paying a higher tax rate than billionaires and the biggest corporations.
But
I plan on making that fair.
But we're dealing with the real world here.
But the real world includes...
How are you going to get this through Congress?
You know, when you talk quietly with a lot of folks in Congress, they know exactly what I'm talking about because their constituents know exactly what I'm talking about. Their constituents are those firefighters and teachers and nurses. Their constituents are middle-class, hardworking folk.
And Congress has shown no inclination to move in your direction. A quarter of registered voters still say they don't know you. They don't know what makes you tick. And why do you think that is? What's the disconnect?
It's an election, Bill. And I take it seriously that I have to earn everyone's vote. This is an election for president of the United States. No one should be able to take for granted that they can just declare themselves a candidate and automatically receive support. You have to earn it. And that's what I intend to do.
Let me tell you what your critics and the columnists say.
Okay.
They say that the reason so many voters don't know you is that you have changed your position on so many things. You were against fracking, now you're for it. You supported looser immigration policies, now you're tightening them up. You were for Medicare for all. Now you're not. So many that people don't truly know what you believe or what you stand for. And I know you've heard that.
In the last 4 years, I have been Vice President of the United States. And I have been traveling our country. And I have been listening to folks and seeking what is possible in terms of common ground. I believe in building consensus. We are a diverse people. Geographically, regionally, in terms of where we are in our backgrounds. And what the American people do want is that we have leaders who can build consensus, where we can figure out compromise and understand it's not a bad thing, as long as you don't compromise your values, to find common sense solutions. And that has been my approach.
You recently visited the southern border and embraced President Biden's recent crackdown on asylum seekers. And that crackdown produced an almost immediate and dramatic decrease in the number of border crossings. If that's the right answer now, why didn't your administration take those steps in 2021?
The first bill we proposed to Congress was to fix our broken immigration system, knowing that if you want to actually fix it, we need Congress to act. It was not taken up. Fast forward to a moment when a bipartisan group of members of the United States Senate, including one of the most conservative members of the United States Senate, got together, came up with a border security bill. Well, guess what happened? Donald Trump got word that this bill was afoot and could be passed, and he wants to run on a problem instead of fixing a problem, so he told his buddies in Congress, kill the bill, don't let it move forward.
But But I've been covering the border for years. And so I know this is not a problem that started with your administration.
Correct, correct.
But there was an historic flood of undocumented immigrants coming across the border the first 3 years of your administration. As a matter of fact, arrivals quadrupled from the last year of President Trump. Was it a mistake to loosen the immigration policies as much as you did?
It's a long-standing problem. And solutions are at hand. And from day one, literally, we have been offering solutions.
What I was asking was it a mistake to kind of allow that flood to happen in the first place?
I think the policies that we have been proposing are about fixing a problem, not promoting a problem. Okay?
But the numbers did quadruple.
And the numbers today, because of what we have done, we have cut the flow of illegal immigration by half. We
have
cut the flow of fentanyl by half. But we need Congress to be able to act to actually fix the problem.
You have